For 3 years in a row now, we have driven north 2 hours from Rio Rancho and camped at the Rihanna campground next to the Abiquiu Reservoir. This year, we expanded the duration of our stay to a full week, Monday through Saturday. Here are some of the things we saw and did. The Rihanna campground sits just a few hundred feet away from the lake, which this year was as high as we'd ever seen it. The campground and the lake are run by the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, and so the facilities are top-notch, and the oversight by sheriffs and park rangers really keep the bad elements out. When not hiking, exploring, or playing in the lake, we spend our time preparing and eating meals, working on crafts or camping skills, building fires, watching outdoor movies, and just taking in the beauty of the vistas all around us. We went on two hikes this year, first to someplace new, the Poshuwinge Indian ruins, believed to have been inhabited by members of today's Tiwa tribe, from 1375 to 1475 AD. The short hike takes you up a steep hill to an overlook, where you can see an outline of the former village that once consisted of over 700 rooms. The ruins were first partially surveyed and excavated in 1885 by Adolf Bandelier. The second hike we took was back to Plaza Blanca. We've been to this spot, located next to the Dar al-Islam Education Center and Mosque, but this time we just kind of wandered around and allowed the kids to climb and explore. The area around Abiquiu celebrates the life and art of Georgia O'Keeffe, who lived in the area for almost 40 years. There's a Georgia O'Keeffe Museum, a restored home, and a variety of tours to places that inspired her art. We chose a quick visit to the Georgia O'Keeffe Welcome Center just south of the village of Abiquiu. Just outside the village of Abiquiu is the Purple Lavender Farm, which includes a functioning lavender farm, a small gift shop, and a meditation circle, which serves as a magical container for meditative experiences. Please note how calm and reflective the grandkids are in these images. For the kids, the highlight of the week were trips to the lake. The water level was up from historical averages almost 30 feet, as underwater picnic tables and shelters attested. Regardless of the weather, including some crazy strong winds, the kids look forward to being in the water, finding cool rocks, going kayaking, and doing something new, cliff diving.
Way too old for this.
The weather, as expected for late June, was hot and at times terribly windy, so living outside for almost a whole week was a challenge, but the regular and quite spectacular in-your-face sunsets made it all worthwhile.